You are young-ish, I would say you're young-ish, and you've decided to delve into this idea of financial planning, which is something that I think for people our age, you're kind of in that in-between zone of should I get someone to help me, should I not, and that's kind of what you guys are trying to do with Grove.
Yeah, so we're trying to reinvent financial planning, make it accessible to people like yourself, like me, and it kind of all started when I was trying to figure this out with my wife, right? Like, can we buy a house? What if we want to have kids? Like, how do we get everything organized? And if you look at the industry, it's filled with really expensive fees. It's inaccessible. Most advisors will wait till you have $500,000 or $1 million to work with you. And if you decide that you're eligible, if you pay their fees, you end up getting crazy, you know, massive documents.
Right. I like that you brought props to show us.
Hundreds and hundreds of pages of like charts, you know, tons and tons and tons of stuff. And it doesn't even make sense.
So how exactly does Grove change that narrative?
Yeah, so we've built software to try to make a team of real human advisors much more efficient. So we can live in a conversation with them online. They can message us, they can text us. When we deliver advice, we do it with, you know, well-designed things on the internet. We don't deliver plans to people.
And no paper packets?
No, we don't have any paper packets. With Grove right now, we have a team of certified financial planners. And the first step in the process is for you to fill out a profile to let us get to know you a little bit, to share information about where you work, to sync your accounts so we understand your finances, and then schedule a call with one of our CFPs where we'll actually go into the really important stuff that doesn't really work well online, which is digging into your goals, digging into how much risk you're willing to be comfortable with, and kind of what kind of balance you're comfortable with of things that you really care about, things that you don't always care about, and trying to find a happy medium of where you end up.
What can you guys do that other financial services can't?
Yeah, so compared to the traditional ones, we can just be more accessible. So if the average cost is $2,500 or needs you to have $1 million, you know, we charge $600 a year, which is, you know, a fraction of that cost, and we have no minimum amount of assets to work with us. Another one is we can do it on people's time. So you can join a call in the evening, you can join a call on the weekend, you can do it all virtually so you don't have to, you know, go into an office and work with someone. And then we can share the information in a way that just makes sense to people. And I owe a lot of that to, you know, our design team and making the advice more understandable and not a, you know, a massive document.
Yeah, like, can we look at specific examples there?
Yeah, so if I'm looking at this, you know, sample financial plan for Jim Jones and Jill Jones, you know, it says, hey, it appears you may run out of money before the last survivor's life expectancy. Here are some possible options to consider to improve your situation. One is shorten your life expectancy assumption.
So that's it.
That's just written on a piece of paper. It doesn't make practical sense. And that's the way software has traditionally been used in financial planning. And we've built software that allows our advisors to go in and make sure that the answer makes sense and the answer lines up with what people want or what's possible, so that we're not telling someone, oh, you know, here's how to achieve your dreams. Just, you know, get your employer to double your salary. Like,
right.
That's obviously, that will help, but it's not possible.
What kind of specific advice do you guys give?
Yeah, so one of the goals for us is to come together with a client on a scenario that's both in the realm of possibility and, you know, will work out. So it might not be that you could buy a $15 million house, but if you wanted to buy a $600,000 house and you want to do it in 2 years and we want to help you do that, instead of saying, great, you're on track, we would say, okay, we recommend you open up a high yield savings account to start saving for your down payment. Because, you know, as we know, the market can be risky and you wouldn't want money that you need in a couple years to have any kind of major impact. And so we tell them, here's what we recommend for places that you could open that account to get the best high yield savings interest rate. Here's how much the money we think you should put in now and where it should come from, whether it's, you know, your checking account or your brokerage account. And then each year we'll remind you and let you know in advance, here's how much you need to be contributing to be on the right path.